It's New Year and I just woke up with this. It's all red and so sleep was like this. I mean, I woke up out of that thing happening. So I'm dealing with this. So it's just surprising that I'm not at all having the starvation to as small as this thing. I tried to pick it up and eat it, and I was like, my tummy felt like full. So it's few days that I'm not at all having this starvation because of the routines being messed up. Like I'm finding it difficult to eat even this or also that, as simple as those things. Also, I looked up about the documentary making process and it included interviews and, you know, storytelling. Yeah, and many other things. And also it has pros and cons as well, because actual documentary filmmaking process, it said like it includes most of the actual footages, but yet what we see on television or OTT is that like most of the documentary, so-called documentary, filmed as a like recreative things. So yeah, but the only pros is that we are going through this documentation. I think it's kind of hybrid we are doing. And yeah, so I thought that okay, I'll have to go back to my usual routine, not just for myself but also to continue this journey. And yeah, I'm going to do breathing exercise, and I have lots of pending works and fixes to make about this editing software and editing 2 days of videos. So when things get tough, right, the first thing to be doing is to withdraw from it. So I'm doing that. I was just singing song with lyrics. Yeah, and also I ate a bit, because I was singing, it consumes a lot of energy for me personally. Yeah, and also I'm doing some, you know, these things. So yeah, so I was just clearing my shit box in the toilet and I got to start think that, and I started to realize that I went from nothing, like being frozen in time, to losing track of time. Like I don't know when I'm shitting, when I'm bathing, when I'm exercising, I don't know, day and night, it's all messed up. And since I had to keep track of these things because it's kind of programmed life I'm living. Like everything has to be in balance, even bathing. Like 2 to 3 days, if I don't bath between that exact timeline, the body becomes more stiff or I don't know what not. Also, if I regularly bath, it becomes overstressing. So yeah, that sort of thing. And I couldn't take it. Not just that, but whatever is happening, it's, I don't know, it's like blank. So I thought like, okay, let me take some time off. And I just felt like, okay, I'll just lie down or take a bit of rest. Bye. I don't know if it's a good thing or bad thing. I was trying to take off my mind and take a bit of rest, and again I'm back into doing this. It's kind of drive, but out of proportion. It's hard to figure out to do anything at all apart from this soul thing, and it has consequence on health. So now the challenge is that I think it's holiday today on Apple thing. There's no one to answer the give support today. Actually today it's New Year, I think it's holiday there as well. And clearing that stuff, I cannot edit because it is filled with this. So I need to export this, and to export this, I don't know
It's taking a lot of space. So, you know, it's not at all easy. See, it's like 400 GB almost. I don't know why is it taking so much space. What is that?
Yeah. So I can take risks and try to fix it myself, but the risk is high. I could lose the entire video edited. So yeah, fuck me. I realized that I can use save it in the external hard drive. Like, I did not know, I just tried it and it happened. So I'm still not sure if it's going to import or if there is going to be an issue, but I'm like feeling a lot better. So I think it is better that now I do some, you know, activity to help myself with some of the exercise or stiffness, mentality, everything. Holy smoke, oh my god. It seems like it's exporting, but I'm not sure. Holy smoke. I don't know how I'm going to deal with today. And first, it just feels like I need to stop recording because I have like 2 days pending file to edit and it's all messed up. I mean, to edit, nothing is clear what I've spoken. And editing takes like 8 hours to edit. I mean, like 4 hours to edit one on a average with what timeline or the way I'm editing. Not editing big, but still. Longer time, right? Holy smoke. It's 3 now, I'm not even hungry for morning, so that's the scene. My food there, so morning I didn't have, like I said, I don't want. Also, I'm in no mood to do exercise. Also, all the drive is in that I need to finish that work somehow, or else I'm screwed. That's the thing which is going in my mind. And also, it's not that I'll be fucked for real. But I am used to getting fucked for real a lot many times. I'm not going to take it serious. So you got to have this mentality and you have this choice of if it works or not at crucial situations like life deciding moments, be it anything, because it is common for all, everyone goes through it, right? So if you have that mentality that okay, it's not going to be a big deal, you're going to survive still. So if you have that mentality, it becomes easier for you to bounce back. Yeah, holy smoke. So there's an error again, even trying to connect with this one. So lots of things are going out of hand, and it is somewhat kind of challenging that how to look myself, how I'm going to deal with all this messed up stuff. But also it's having impact on health, that is the thing which I'm little bothered. So you see, even the food and all, right? I don't know how I'm working, how my mind is working. I'm not eating most of the time. I'm not working out most of the time, but I'm still kind of going through it. So We'll see. Sometimes it's just an easy fix that I just tried it again, retried it, and it just worked. So yeah, when things doesn't work, the first thing you do is just try again. Like this. I mean, it depends, but yeah. Because it worked for me quite some times in editing and stuff. So yeah. And also I went on to see some car challenges to get off that pressure and have a boost, and it really worked. So yeah, you can do it on, you know, if you are going through something like pressurized environment or something like this, you can go and watch some challenges in your own interest of subject. Every subject has a challenge, okay? So, and yeah, car building, it's no easy task. So yeah, it was motivating, and it was Texas, no, Lexus. So it was Lexus, a very underrated car. And what a legend, Naruse, Akio Toyoda, and Tanahashi. I think I'm feeling a lot better now. And also one more thing I forgot to say about this, you know, content creation things, guys. There are so many things going on when you are creating something. And the title or thumbnail or anything you're associating initially, it has to be a bigger noun. For example, IPL is a bigger noun, right? So if you use something of bigger noun, and it has to be relatable, all right? So then it's more of a opportunity to be visible on the social media. Yeah, with so many things going on, to choose the right thing at the right start is one of the thing, because I think it's kind of a syndrome or something. Today we go through lots of fucking information and we forget the basics. So yeah, fortunately I knew it, and also things fell into place, and also it was a fucking brave decision, I guess. It's like 5:15 now. I got to edit 2 videos and I don't know what the fuck to do about it, but I have a good attitude towards it. So then it works, I guess. Let's see. Meanwhile, I had food as well, and also a bit of exercise while having food itself, because there's no much time for things to be wasted, and I'm not someone who's, you know, into all this dedicated and all this stuff. I think this is what it needs to do something. But yeah, it's your choice at the end of the day. I mean, if you figure out even better, awesome. I'm not saying like this is the thing you have to do it, but most of the things requires this. See, for example, I was all into bikes and cars racing. It was so fucking natural to me. I did not even have to, there was no negative aspect to it at all. Even if they pay me or don't pay me, like, I was so fucking happy just doing that. Yeah. Okay, it's a big topic. Like, the world itself is fucked in the name of advancement, like, technology and civilization and whatnot. But if you see the stats, that people are worst at this phase, mentally and lots of things. It was just so much fun just roaming around the jungle and just fighting a bit, love, just beautiful things. And now it's so fucking complicated. So anyway, let's deal with this. So, you know, just editing alone, it's not working out for my health. So I figured a way that I do edit while doing exercise. Like,
it's just, you know, coordinated screwing, guys.
I can listen to that. That was a bad one to start with. Alright, so yeah, I'll listen that, and also I'll be like, any moment or anything apart from just sitting. Yeah, this is the way. So yeah, peace, bye. No, actually it's not helping, so it needs like full focus, I guess. But I'm just, you know, doing few things in between. But not much. It requires all attention, so We'll see. Holy man. You see, once I learn to convey things or get out of this tough zone, right? Like dealing with the editing issues and whatever. When I get used to that and it becomes normal, I think I'm hoping for that day soon too. Come. So yeah, till then it'll be like this, a bit tough. So when you are going through an unfamiliar work environment or unfamiliar journey, it's easy to get distracted because everything is new and you tend to take a break from what you're doing and try to do something else. And again, that gets stressed and again you jump on to do other things. So it's important to note that only when we finish one specific thing, the stress reduces. If we keep on jumping, we'll keep on jumping. So actually I was about to do that and I got realized, okay, this is pretty common and I need to say it. Like I was trying to, you know, do so many things actually. It wasn't working. And I just realized, okay, this is what's happening with me. So at this point of time, because of those pending, you know, editing issues and all, I got one of the extra file pending and I'm just editing that since evening. It's like 9. I got one more to edit. God knows what I'm going to do with that. But yeah, there are some basic things. Some things we can avoid with some measures to take off the pressure. And some things we got to go through that mindset for. Take it on with courage and stuff. Yeah. And also while I was editing, I just realized like how fucking boring it is. But the thing is, this is the actual reality where no one shows. Even I'm just realizing while I'm going through it, I never thought it would be this easy. My idea was like so fucking magnificent that I thought like, okay, so easy. I figured out the plan. I can do it. But reality, holy moly. It's no fun, honestly. No fun, initially at least. Yeah, I mean, this phase itself is like initial phase I'm going through. I got some lunchtime. I was like, okay, cool. Let me just take off the pressure of editing and watch something else. And what I'm going to do about today's videos, editing. God bless me. And that's all. I don't know, bro. And it's New Year, bro. Fucking New Year. So yeah, I'll try to make the video interesting, but basically what happens is, am I talking too much? And also, like it took like 5 hours again to edit one video. At some day I need to edit 2 videos on a single day. How am I going to do that is the task. Holy moly. Yeah, don't keep the work pending, bro. I thought we'd take a break and I was thinking about the documentary kind of thing I was watching about the Lexus. And this guy is a legend. I mean, he's like me. Like if I were only a president of a car company. So he's awesome. And there is some similarity between Tamil and Japanese, the positive criterias. So I always liked Japan and this guy being like me, it's awesome. Like, he went against most of the staffs and departments in his own company. That was fucking cool to do. And that's how Lexus was born. It's like, if you take any car company building any specific car, more than a car, it's like project, not a regular car. The challenges, it's always inspiring and it's mega to watch. You know, before starting this 100 days journey, I was in this narrow physical and mental loop of same things, and it was quite a bit struggle. Then I thought, like, okay, let me learn something new, and I thought to learn a different language. I thought it would keep my mind healthy. Then I thought, like, okay, we'll learn Italian because I like Italians. So yeah, here we are, and since this 100 days journey started, I still want to learn, but it's not happening. It's too much. Like, it's 12 now. Still, it's going to be like 5 hours of work. And in between that, I'm literally not getting up from editing for hours and hours and hours. Like, you can say 60% of the time of the day. So I'm not going to edit for 5 hours now. I'll be messed up tomorrow for you know, mentally, physically, both. Fuck. So yeah, like, from nothing, like being from nothing to doing everything on an overnight decision, it is like, I have never been this transformative in my life, and I think it's so important for me. That is why I'm just getting fucked up over and over. So this is how you two have to be to achieve something. And usually I don't like into achieve something. I prioritize more on happiness. And since my life got messed up, it's hard to chase my happiness, which is racing and stuff. And out of consequence, I'm here, or else I seriously wouldn't be doing all this. It's a misery. Maybe it would pay off later, but still, this is not me. Yeah. Then things get stressed. I just want to talk out, so I just started saying things. Bye-bye. So actually, before this 100 days journey, I used to struggle to find some drive, and when I used to not get any drive or traction to drive, I used to get back to distraction, and that's how it used to be. And now with this journey, it just feels like overstress, but still, when I go to distraction, it just feels calm. And as soon as I feel that calmness, it just feels like I want to get back to the drive. If I'm not sleepy, I feel like I get back to the drive. Also, the distraction factor is also there still, that I want to distract myself. I'm just in that withdrawal phase where everything is kind of messing up. I have the urge to be distracted, and when I go and get distracted, yeah, this drive is pulling me. These things. Yeah. And also, distraction is good, and making a decision is even more important thing. Decision like, see, I just tried to edit, like it's like 1 a.m. I just couldn't go further. I was pushing, try to push a bit to edit further and work on that. I was mentally not being very productive, started to, you know, stressed. Then I decided that, okay, I got to figure out something to sustain in this 100 days journey. And yeah, since it's about figuring out life, I came up with some idea, which I'll tell tomorrow. And yeah, also I had to make a choice, find an alternative, and I stopped editing. I couldn't. Then I'm like, cool, now I'm like, awesome. And I'm back to salvi, vorrei l'antipasto per favore italiano. Like, I get that. So when you make a decision, right, it feels like good. Not decision, when we accept, yes, when we accept something and withdraw from something, it feels good. And also there is some certain subtle criteria between Tamil and Italian, especially me. It just, I can relate more, like they're more fun loving, they prioritize that. And also they're still having that primitive aspect, the adrenaline and the passion for something they like. And also it's all subtle. So yeah, that's kind of the gene aspect. So yeah, and that's the kind of streaks we follow.